Hey everybody, welcome back to some more Kirby and the Forgotten Land. And in today's episode, we're going to be taking on the Tropical of Terror, or the Tropical Terror, whichever way you want to pronounce it. Now, with this stage, there's quite a few objectives to do. First, we've got to clear the stage, that will give us 3 bottled ease. We've also got to destroy the woods roots, that will give us 1. We've got to clear this tropical stage by using the copy ability. We've got to clear the stage in under 2 minutes. We got to clear the stage, not take any damage, and then we also got to get the Noble Ranger Blueprint. Now, this will take me a few tries to get all of these, so we won't do it in the first run, sadly, but we're going to try and get as many as possible. So I'm also going to clear the stage in today's part, and then we're going to also, you know, destroy the roots. We're also going to, you know, try and do it without taking any damage, of course, but we might take us like 2 or 3 times to get them all, but we'll mostly get about 3 of them in the first run. So let's begin. And for this one, I would say use the fire ability would be your best bet, but also the ranger ability when you upgrade it is something you can do to take damage, and we definitely will show how to do that, which I found to mostly be the easiest way to do things is when you use different abilities and come back and forth, which I love, but the fact that they give you multiple ways of doing it. But if you don't have the fire ability, it will be here. The only problem is, if you want to get the range one, you will have to go back to your hub world. Just so that way, you can add it from the shop and use it to your advantage. Now, there were some glitches that I saw where you can skip the opening scene, which I believe is just around here. I don't know if this still works. Okay, no, it doesn't. I might have done it wrong. But it might have been patched. I really didn't watch the video thoroughly, so I can't really tell if it was done correctly or not. But oh, the unfriendly frond of tropical woods. There we go. Oh, there we go. Got him down the half. We do get blown back, but that doesn't count towards damage. There we go. Okay, I did get some damage done by the roots, but we can grab the achievement of destroying the roots. Yeah, so I'm not going to get the one without taking any damage. There we go. Oh, and I did it. Hopefully that's under 2 minutes. Obviously, I wasn't the best. I've never amped these boss fights, so I always take like 3 or 4 times to get everything I need. But that should be under 2 minutes. I'm hoping that it is. Clear the stage in under 2 minutes. Got that one. And we also got the blueprint, which is another great thing. And now we got this one as well. So we actually got... Four. So we only need 2 more without taking any damage and only using copy abilities, which is going to be the most difficult one because you have to wait for the stars. So that's great, you know. Oh, I don't love that. Only 2 more to go, but we will head back to the hub world to upgrade to the ranger ability. I know most people don't go for 100%, which I understand, but for me, with these games, they're kind of like very simple. So it's kind of like an easy thing to do, just to go back and forth. And we're back to town automatically, which is strange. I'm guessing some other places are opened up. The ranger ability can now be evolved. Pay a visit to Waldy's weapon shop. We will definitely do that. Oh, a new wise Waldy has arrived in town. He'll give you tips on finding missing blueprints and a whole lot more. I don't know why he would give us tips to find blueprints, because they're mostly easy to find throughout the levels. But again, let's talk to this guy. Let's see what he's got. How do you do? They call me Wise the Worldy. After I landed here, I found the mysterious book. It lists the location of undiscovered blueprints. It also collects high scores and tons of other info from around the world. If you'd like to know more, I'm happy to share. You haven't missed any blueprints thus far. If I read about any new blueprints or locations, I'll help you find it. The most popular Worldy's calf item is the Maximum Tomato. It has over 7 million orders. Jesus Christ, that's from the amount of people who play this game. That's how many people have brought the Maximum Tomato. The number of star coins you collected so far is 8,287. The combined total of star coins collected all over the world is 56 billion. Oh my God. Damn. Would you like to hear more? Yeah, sure, let's hear more. Let's see. The world record for defeating Tropical Woods is 5 minutes and 23 seconds with the normal ability. When I say Carmouth Cake, do you get a bit hungry? The item has been eaten free. Oh, Jesus Christ. The Pop Flowers. You helped 77 bloom during your adventure. The combined total of bloom pop flowers is over 500 million. Jesus Christ! Would you like to hear more? I'm good. Jesus Christ, the amount of... That's good. It tells you how much you've done and how much the world has done, but blimey hell, that is a lot. Jesus Christ. Alright, time to upgrade the ranger ability. Yep, a new upgrade. There we go. Oh, it's so much better when it's upgraded. You have no idea how powerful it is. Alright. Yep, definitely going to evolve it. The rapid fire. That's what it is. Comes down to is the rapid fire. The power I don't really care about at the moment. We got to admit though, that is sick. Oh, and we're definitely going to skip this. We don't really need to. But look at that. I'm dual wielding. Right. Now it's time to head to the world map. Because we got some bosses to defeat. Even though now we can unlock the next stage. Look, literally chose the cutscene to the next world. World 3. Which is by far the best one so far I've played up to. Because it's all theme park related. And I remember when I live streamed, this was the world I got up to. And it's so much fun to play. I could probably redo it again and have the time of my life. Like, look at that. Welcome to Wanderer. Right, we will definitely come do that. We've got to, like, you know, defeat this guy again. Let's defeat the stage without taking any damage. Let's do this. There we go. Defeat him without taking any damage. Ah, woo! Now we just have to do it, which is the most annoying part, is that we have to redo it. With only using copy abilities. Without using copy abilities, so we have to pick up the stars and shoot it at him. Oh god, it's going to be annoying. Because it's not something you can do. It might not take me my first try, but I'll do my best with it. There we go, defeated it without using the copy ability. I could have done it without taking damage, but I ended up rushing it towards the end and I took damage. So I could have done it without taking damage on this part if I needed to. But there we go. Triple Terror has been completed 100% and World 2 is now cleared. For the time being, we still have to go back and do all the bonus stages. So we will definitely check them out now, just to get them out of the way, you know, because the boss stage is all very, like, you know, very short, not that long, doesn't really fulfill an episode. So I feel like I'm going to go around and try and do all the excess bonus stages. You saved all the worldies in every day, every bay coast. Right, now we have to go back and do all these lovely missions. That one's done. This one needs to be done. This is Clam Cutter. Gotta do it in 1 minute. So let's see if we can do it. Hopefully it's not that difficult. Getting it under the time just gives you a bonus coins. As long as we get, you know, the rare gem, that's all that matters. Okay, I literally hated the cutter tool. I know there's meant to be like a trick where you can hold it and have it go where you want to. I just can't remember how to do it. Yeah, so I may have to do a tutorial on how to learn the cutter tool ability. But we got the red gem star anyway. So I guess that's all that matters. Yeah, that's all that matters. There's going to be some more difficult ones, I know. Do Oh, there's a search spot here. Grab that coin. This one's the tornado treasure. This one is under 30 seconds. Okay. Hopefully I can do it under 30 seconds, you know? There we go. Was that under 30 seconds? I like to think that it's under 30 seconds. 35. A new personal best. I was 5 seconds short. So maybe if I took more shortcuts, it probably would have been much under. But that was a very easy one. Wasn't difficult at all. I don't understand why you would need the times for. I don't feel like it's necessary in this kind of like game. To get the fastest. This is Sword Treasures, which is 1 star, so the difficulty is very easily. Have I upgraded my sword? No, I haven't. It's still the same level 1 Link Sword. Now, eventually when I do upgrade them, they'll be more powerful. And voila, the mission is done. Did I get under 1 minute? Probably didn't. Nope, 1 minute 9 seconds. Jesus Christ, why am I so close but so far off at the same time? Up to 12 rare gems. Those will help us upgrade our power-ups. I would say probably collect them mostly in the early stages as they will be the most easiest. I'm guessing the further we go into a story, or there's a search bit here. Oh, there's a purple one. Nice rare one. The more we go into the worlds, the more harder these kind of bonus missions like Treasure Roads will be. But for now, do them while you can instead of saving coming back later. Well, this could be, this definitely has to be a fast one, it has to be. The best. Oh, target time was 45 seconds, oh come on! Really? Oh my god, I was thinking, yeah, personal best, yeah, and I looked below, but 45 seconds, well, screw you then. God damn it. I'm never going to get a new record on these. The drill treasure. Yeah, sure. Let's do the drill one. How can I mess this one up? Alright, let's see my awful time, you know? Yeah, I was never gonna get 1 minute 10. I'm too slow, man, and my timing's off, and my patterns are all difficult and all over the place. But I still got that rare stone. Thank God you get the rare stone just for beating the stage. Imagine if you had to get the record time. Oh my God, I would hate it. I would hate it so much. And this is the last one, the Volcano Fire Treasure. Let's do it. My voice is getting much better. It feels much better. Kind of a bit crooky now and then in certain places, but overall, yeah, I'll say it's pretty good. Okay, this one is definitely not up there in the record for 107. Yeah, if I didn't mess up on that last stage, I could have done it. I feel like there is a way to do it, but you have to jump and speed ahead and take damage wherever you can. So, but now I say that's pretty good results, you know. We definitely did quite a lot. You know, so yeah, hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. Next time we'll be taking on the first level in World 3. Hope you guys enjoyed. Remember to leave a like, comment, subscribe, turn post notification by clicking that bell icon. And I'll see you in the next one. But until then, take care, everybody.